Hey, what's up everyone? We're back with another tutorial in Cubase Elements 8. I'm going to teach you how to get it so that you can mix your Groove Agent drums in the Mix Console. So let's open up an instance of Groove Agent. Just add an instrument track, Groove Agent SE, add track. And so this will be a tutorial for Acoustic Agent with Beat Agent and the other kits. I think you can just click on the pad and assign the output. But this is for if you're using acoustic type drum sets. So let's put in an acoustic type drum set with Groove Agent. So here's Groove Agent. I've added the track. And I'll just use a Trip to Texas because I know that's a kit with a sound that's not too bad. So the kit is loaded and I've already made this MIDI pattern, and this is funny. If any of you have ever seen the show The Sopranos, in one of the later seasons, the son, Anthony Soprano Jr., gets a drum set, and the producers of the show must have had a kid with the drum set or something, because every time you hear him practicing in the show, he plays this beat. So that's the beat we'll be working with. I just wrote that in MIDI because I thought it would be funny. So as you can see, there's a lot of parameters, you know, room, overhead, bleed, tune, attack, that type of thing. And you'll still need to, you know, tweak those parameters to your taste. But then you have the mix window. And in this mix window, you can basically do everything, but it's kind of tiny and you can't resize it because the programmers at Steinberg thought that that wasn't something you'd want. If you want to use effects, you have to use these auxiliary sends, so you need to add effects here and then add, you know, aux sends to those effects from this console. So what if you don't want to do that? Well, there's a way to get this set up in your mix window, and the way you do that is by assigning outputs to Groove Agent. So we'll just assign them. See here at this top it says kit mix. Instead, we'll just assign each one an out, so that'll be out 2, out 3 for the snare, out 4 for the hi-hats, out 5 for the toms, out 6 for the cymbals. We're not using percussion, so out 7 for the room mics, and out 8 for the overhead mics. Now, you think you might be able to just activate the outputs and go for it, but for the purposes of this tutorial, I'll show you something. You can reset everything to unity gain. So just hold down the control button and click on them, and they'll all go back to unity gain. And then you may need to go through each one and turn off the channel strip functions for the Groove Agent mixer. So if you see the yellow light here, just click on it. You'll turn off the EQ. Then you can EQ it from within the mix console. EQ, compression, tape saturation, envelope shaper, all that goodness. So now what we have is a dry kit, and that'll sound like this. And so now we need to activate the outputs. So in order to do that, we hit the F11 key on our keyboard to bring up the instrument rack. And I think when you first get Cubase, it'll be like racked up, like right here on the side of your screen with the media bay, and it'll take up like half of your screen, so you don't get half of the project window. So I just got rid of it. So if you have it, boom, you got the instrument rack right where you need it. But if you don't have it, you can use it by hitting F11. The VST instrument rack will come up, and then all you need to do is see this button right here. It'll say activate outputs. You click on that, and then how many did we use? We used up to 8. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then they're active. So you'll see in your mix window, if you bring up by hitting F3, there they are. But we are going to need to see where we mapped them to. So let's open up Groove Agent again. Go back to the mix console. So it's kick, snare, and unfortunately Groove Agent doesn't figure this out. If you you have to do it yourself. Hi-hat, toms, cymbals, room and overhead. Room, overhead. And you can put those on a bus or whatever and, you know, do compression in stages and EQ in stages. But then we have... So if we solo the groove agent track that everything was coming out of before, you don't hear any sound because... And you have ability to solo everything. So that's just a quick tip on how to assign outputs from the acoustic agent so that you can actually mix the drum set here. So you'd mix to your heart's content, adding EQ and plugins like, I don't know, compression or even delay or reverb, or you could set up sends and just send certain amounts of the drums. But it's a little bit more flexibility than offered by the mix window here in Groove Agent. So I hope you find this useful. Have a great day. Bye.